Hello everyone. In the previous session, we have discussed about the seven Fayol's principles of management. Now in this session, we will continue with the eighth principle, that is centralization and decentralization. Now what is centralization? Centralization means where the decision-making authority is with the top management. That means all the decisions related to the business organization will be taken by top management. And decentralization means evenly distribution of power at every level of management, where the powers are distributed at every level of management, that is top level, middle level and lower level. Now according to Fayol, a company must not be completely centralized or completely decentralized, but there must be a combination of both depending upon the nature and size of organization. Which means in small organization where there are less number of employees, then all the decisions relating to the business activities will be taken by top management. Whereas in large organization, where there are large number of employees, then there is a need of distribution of power at every level of management. Every level of management means top level, middle level and lower level. Okay, so decentralization technique will be applied in large organization. For example, centralization policies can be applied on major decisions relating to setting up of organizational goals, plans and policies of the organization. But decentralization policy can be applied on routine work such as purchase of raw materials, fixing targets of workers, etc. Next principle is principle of scalar chain. Now scalar chain means line of authority or chain of superiors from highest to lowest rank, or we can say it is a systematic way of communication from top level to lower level or from lower level to top level. According to Fayol, this chain must be followed strictly in the organization. So we will understand this principle with the help of the diagram. Okay, now see in this diagram, A has a two line of authority. Now if E wants to contact to O, then he will have to follow the chain, that is he will have to go through D, then D to C, C to B, B to A, then A to L, L to M, M to N and finally then N to O. So we can see it is a long process, and if the there is a chances of gap if the chain is broken. So in case of emergency or urgent information, Fayol has permitted a shortcut in the chain which is called gangplank. Now what is gangplank? Gangplank means it permits direct communication between the employees working at the same level of authority without following the scalar chain. Now next principle is principle of order. So in this principle, order here doesn't mean to command. It refers to the orderly arrangement of men and material, that is fixed place for everything and everyone in the organization. Now what does fixed place means? Fixed place means to keep every material and things used in the organization, seat or cabin for every employee of the organization, so that no time and energy is wasted in search of any material or item. Okay, so basically it means proper arrangement of everything and everyone in the organization. Now the next principle is principle of equity. So what is equity? Equity basically refers to the fair and equal treatment to the employees so that they can put their maximum efforts. For example, if a manager is biased in dealing with the employees, then employees will get dissatisfied and will not contribute their maximum capacity. So it means application of same disciplinary rules, leave rules in the same way irrespective of their grade, position and gender. For example, role for granting medical leave to an employee should be same irrespective of their position, grade or gender. Next principle is stability of tenure of personnel, which means there should be no frequent termination and transfer, because we know it takes time to a person to learn and get settled on a job, and by the time he gets settled, he receives transfer order. So all this leads to the wastage of resources and also the employee is not able to contribute to the best of his organization. According to this principle of management, a job security must be provided to the employees, because with the feeling of insecurity for the job, the employees cannot contribute their maximum. So there should be stability of tenure of personnel, as frequent turnover of employees is bad for the organization. Next principle is initiative. Now, what is initiative? Fayol suggested that employees in the organization must be given an opportunity to take some initiative in making and executing a plan, as it gives immense satisfaction to the employees. So when the managers welcome the ideas and suggestions of the employees before framing the plan, the employees get motivated and they implement the plan and follow the plan with their maximum effort. So we can say initiative is the first step with the self-motivation. Now the last principle is esprit de corps. What does it mean? It means the management must encourage and promote the team spirit, unity and harmony. This will bring coordination and cooperation in organization, which means the manager should motivate the employees to work in unity. They should direct the efforts of all the employees towards a common goal. And also the manager should replace I with we. What does it mean? It means if I is replaced with we, this will give rise to mutual trust and belongingness among the team members. So we have learned all the 14 Fayol principles of management. Now in the next session, we will discuss about the Taylor's scientific principles of management. So that's all for today. Thank you.